Travers, thanks. Sheriff Marlin Gusman testified for more than 4 hours this morning as part of the consent decree hearings. WDSU reporter Andy Cunningham joins us now live from federal court with when the judge could make a decision.
Well, Scott, Judge Lance Afric said he didn't know exactly when he would be making his ruling, but said it would likely come before the consent decree funding hearing, which is currently scheduled for late May. Sheriff Marlin Gusman spoke briefly with reporters as he left federal court this afternoon, minutes after being questioned about those jaw-dropping videos released earlier this week.
And right now, Sheriff, you don't want to say anything?
Gusman called the videos terrible and said as soon as he was made aware of them, he launched an immediate investigation. But he disagreed with correctional experts who testified in federal court earlier this week that the videos prove he's a dysfunctional leader and operates one of the worst jails in America.
I came here today to just see how he would explain himself.
Michelle Hitzman-Perdomo said the sheriff's testimony didn't surprise her one bit.
But I don't expect him to take responsibility because he hasn't so far.
Hitzman Perdomo testified Wednesday in 2010. Her brother, Michael Hitzman, at the OPP on a drug charge, killed himself while on suicide watch.
No one's watching, right? So my brother was able to hang himself because no one was watching. He was dead for an hour before they were able to get him down or found him.
That's why she and others like Donna Goche, who have lost loved ones in the OPP, argue the consent decree is crucial, a position the Southern Poverty Law Center argued all week.
We had three really powerful days of evidence. We had some really brave clients who got on the stand and talked about their experiences in the jail, and then the court also heard from experts. We're hopeful for a good outcome and that we're really finally on the path to reforming the jail.
And coming up at 6 o'clock here on WDSU, you'll hear from a recently released OPP inmate who says it's actually a lot worse in the prison than what we saw in those recently released videos. Reporting on your side live at the federal courthouse, Sandy Cunningham, WDSU News.